I'm Dwarak. In this presentation, we are going to look at how we think about PyTorch ecosystem and how we will be growing it even further. Earlier today, Lynn talked about the three main themes that are important for sustaining rapid research, innovation, and hypergrowth in production. In this session, I'm going to focus on the PyTorch ecosystem and the investments we are planning to make to not only sustain the growth, but take it to the next level. But first, I want to make two claims. The success of the PyTorch is highly dependent on our ecosystem growth. In fact, the community and the ecosystem are 1,000x more valuable than the actual framework itself. My second claim is, for us to grow the ecosystem 10x more, it is super important for us to invest and build extension points for the ecosystem. Let's first investigate these claims on how PyTorch got to where it is today. What is PyTorch really? PyTorch is a standard front-end memory format for tensor processing. The way we blow up the authoring ecosystem here is that we design all primitives in PyTorch to be interoperable, even on different compute. This, in turn, created a massive ecosystem of primitives and implementations on top of the PyTorch, extending it to, for example, custom operators, custom modules, and custom optimizers. Second, PyTorch has a registration and dispatch system. The goal of this is for anyone to extend execution engine, example, operator set, and still be fully interoperable and even extending it to a different hardware. This created a massive acceleration ecosystem to improve the execution of PyTorch programs. Examples here include operators, compilers, and hardware. A unified front-end, data format, registration, and dispatch system are all domain agnostic. For batteries included experience, we provide hardened out-of-the-box features to speed up AI authoring experience. Some examples here are out-of-the-box autograd, data loaders, domain libraries such as Torch Vision, Torch Audio. The goal of the batteries included experience is to support our ecosystem libraries. These domain libraries provide a rich set of built-in AI operations and primitives so that the researchers will be able to do the state-of-the-art research and reproduce papers by using common building blocks rather than rewriting their own. Similarly, industry users will be able to easily adapt the models in their domain using the state-of-the-art techniques. As we see, we have three levels of extension that enables extending PyTorch to several ecosystem components. Things extending PyTorch, which we call the authoring ecosystem, things that are built below PyTorch, which is the execution ecosystem, and things that are built on top of PyTorch, the implementations ecosystem. If you think about this, without these extensions points on the three areas, implementations, authoring, and execution ecosystem, PyTorch would not have been as valuable as it is now. One thing to note is that we didn't invent any of these separately. The innovation was making them work together in a composable and extendable manner. We talked about the PyTorch's playbook so far, and now we will talk about how we are going to take it to the next level. On the authoring ecosystem, we want to make the core front-end language even more extensible for authoring innovators. How are we going to do this? We are building extensible dispatch and subclassing. This means the whole dispatch system itself will be a tool for building more extensible front-ends. What if a third-party library wants to implement a per-operator behavior, like autograd? We are working on the ability to override autograd like compute APIs. Examples include VMAP, quantization. Another example is with Torch Arrow. This extends PyTorch as not only the unified tensor processing front-end, but also unified front-end for data formats, which has arbitrary structured data. So continue to provide extensibility for scientific computing and NumPy compatibility. On batteries included for AI, which is basically about investing in upward ecosystem, we want to blow this up by building out richer batteries included foundation for open source library and framework authors. We are doubling down on our investments in supporting domains, ecosystem libraries, providing hardened table stakes primitives and common extensibility foundations for open source authors and maintainers. With Data Loader V2 and Torch Data, we want to provide performant data loading and performant dataset authoring out of the box. With the new PyTorch Profiler and Torch Bench, we are providing out-of-the-box better debugging and performance measurement experience. On execution ecosystem investments, we are building out more hooks and extensibility to scale and extend production ecosystem for PyTorch. Within the execution ecosystem, on the training and end-to-end workflows, we have built TorchX, which is a unified plugin standards to connect to production deployment and ML lifecycle tools. On the program transformation side, we built TorchFX to make it easier to create composable transformations for compilation and execution engines. We also have PyTorch Mobile to run models on edge devices and TorchServe for out-of-the-box model serving on your cloud provider of choice. With Torch Deploy and Torch Package, we are making it easier and efficient to run inference in multi-threaded environment for production model and also for serving. So far, we talked about investments in the three areas to blow up PyTorch ecosystem even further. Lastly, one important area and commitment we will continue to focus is keeping an open spirit and focus on the success of our ecosystem rather than our own. One example here is we never measure success of PyTorch domain library or a separate repo or a subrepo by itself, but only measure PyTorch and the PyTorch ecosystem overall. By helping ecosystem maintainers succeed, we win. We want to continue doing everything in open, including speculative projects. We want to continue exploring and pushing boundaries by working closely with our developers, users, ecosystem, and partners. Finally, I would be amiss if I did not mention our secret weapon, which is you. Any strategy we have is doomed to fail if our community does not engage. So my request to all of you is simple. Please engage. Please be vocal with your feedback and keep us honest. This will help us build a flourishing, resilient PyTorch ecosystem. Thank you, and I hope you enjoy the rest of the conference.